the things that people actually go to medical school for, because I was very frustrated in first year when I got here and I had to do physicals, I had to do physics, I had to do chemistry. I'm like, I'm here for medicine, I just want to heal people, you know. People still think medical school is 7 years in South Africa. It's actually 6 years. You have to dissect and get to the heart, and then you see the heart, how it is, where it's located, and those things that you actually saw in the textbook is the things that you see on the real heart, which is very
cool. Ladies and gentlemen, medicine is more than just a degree. It's a journey that shapes you, stretches you, and challenges the way you see the world. In this video, we follow Divine, a fifth year medical student at the University of Cape Town, as she opens up about her experiences in the medical school journey. From her first steps to medical school, to the realities of clinical rotations, she shares the highs and lows and the surprises she never saw coming, and also the lessons that shaped her into the person she is becoming. You'll hear her expectations versus the reality, what kept her motivated, and the challenges she had to push through, and her advice to anyone dreaming of studying medicine one day. Whether you're a future med student or already in the journey, or you're just simply curious about life behind the scrubs, this story will give you a real, honest, and inspiring look into med school at UCT. But hey, let's get into it. And before I forget, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and comment. And hey, now let's get into it.
Hi everyone, my name is Divine Matebula. I'm currently a fifth year medical student at the University of Cape Town. So the reason why I chose to study medicine, it was because when growing up, everyone wanted to be a doctor. So I also wanted to be a doctor because of that reason. But in school, I loved natural sciences. I loved life sciences. I just loved how the human body works. It just intrigued me. And I was like, why not be a doctor, you know? And also, I love serving people. I've realized that now, that maybe that's why I actually loved it so much, is because it's about serving people. And yeah, so as early as grade 7, I was sure of what I wanted to do. So the reason why I chose to come to UCT is because UCT is one of the best universities in South Africa and in Africa. So I was like, why not? And yeah, that's the reason why. And it was a little bit far from home. I wanted to be a little bit far from home, but now I'm just like, it's too far. But yeah, that's the reason I wanted to study at UCT. So yeah, I ended up making it to medical school at UCT. So when I came here, my expectations were that I'll get to university, I'll see a lot of people going around, you know, like I'll have my freedom at last. And I got here and the first thing that happened, I was in quarantine for 7 days. So that's because it was COVID year, it was in 2021. So I was in quarantine for 7 days, had my orientation online, didn't even understand a thing. So that's how my medical school journey started. And we had like lectures online throughout the year, a little bit of in-person exposure and all those things. But my first experience wasn't the best. Things started to change once things opened up and COVID-19 restrictions were lifted and we could interact with people. And I think that it taught me a lot about community and being with people and having support from people that you can see, you know, and meeting new people, forming relationships. So a misconception about medical school is that when you come here, you can't have a life, you just have to be on your books every single day, you can't do anything. And that's the idea that I had when I came here. I was like, I'm just here to get my degree, I'm not here to form relationships, friendships, and all those things. But I quickly learned that those things are important. And first year is a lot of work, if I'm being honest. It is a lot, especially for me. The transition from high school to university was a little bit difficult or challenging because of the fact that we were doing everything online. Things change. You don't have the same support that you had from your teachers. You don't have the cheering that you had from your teachers and the motivation per se. You just have to be an adult. You just have to be responsible now, you know, and take control of your own studies. And that had to happen very fast. Some other stuff that did help at UCT, they're like mentors. So in first year, you will have like your own mentor, maybe at res and also at school. They came in very handy, I won't lie to you. It helped with my transition from high school to university. The workload was a lot for first year and second year as well, but things started to become a little bit lighter from third year. which makes me wonder if it's is it that the workload has decreased, or we just like got resistant and we're like now strong and have hard skin and we're used to this whole thing. But yeah, it's quite a lot, but it's doable, and you can also do it while still having a life. And that's what brings me to talking about balance in med school. I think personally, balance, you might not reach the balance where everything is 100. I don't believe that is possible, at least for me, but I think that it's important to prioritize what's important for you at the time. Obviously, you came to Cape Town to study, you came to UCT to study to get this degree, so it's your first priority, but there's certain things that you can also prioritize, which helps you actually get to that goal. So for me, one of the things that I ended up finding myself in, it was church. So I have my career or my education, I have my spiritual life, which I take very seriously, which is something that actually helps me when it comes to my mental health. I won't lie to you, it carried me through, and it still does to this day. Church, the community, the making friends, having people who relate to you, even people who don't relate to you, people from other degrees that you can like, you can vent to. Sometimes people who are going through the same things as you, yes, they might understand you, but we experience things differently. If they're feeling like they're just cruising through and you are complaining, you're having a hard time, they might be like, why are you going through this? So it's important, even when you're making friends, make friends who are not from your faculty, make friends from your faculty, and have a support system, basically. It's very important. Yeah. So medical school at UCT is divided into two, basically, the preclinical years and the clinical years. So the preclinical years involve, it's from like first year to third year, and the clinical years is from like fourth year to the final year, which is the 6 years, which is something people still think medical school is 7 years in South Africa. It's actually 6 years. I think it's just one university where it's 5 years, but it's 6 years. So the first 3 years, basically, it's about theory. So you're going to school every day, you're doing lectures, you're working in groups, and that's the structure that they have at UCT. First year, a lot of things that you do, they expose you to other people, and then you work in groups. So that's another way to make friendships and make connections. And then the last 3 years, it's more clinical. So this is where you start going to the hospital. They don't just like throw you in the hospital. You do start to see patients per se from second year, but those are people who are not sick. It's people who are normal. So they want you to first recognize what normal is and know what normal is, so that when you go to the hospital and see something, you recognize that it's abnormal, and then go and find out what is this thing that is abnormal. So first year is just lectures, you're writing exams and all those things. Second year, second year is actually a lot of content. There are lectures, the tutorials and all those things, but now you are exposed to the clinical space where they give you like normal patients, basically, and you can also practice with your colleagues and your clinical partner. So you do those things and then learn what normal is. And then now third year, they kind of expose you to what clinical years is like, but still while you are in preclinical years. And then fourth year, that's where everything begins, where the things that people actually go to medical school for. Because I was very frustrated in first year when I got here and I had to do physicals, I had to do physics, I had to do chemistry. I'm like, I'm here for medicine, I just wanna heal people, you know. But then that's not how it is. You actually start to go to the hospital from fourth year, like real every day it's hospital. You're rarely in campus. I can count the number of times I've been at campus. So fourth year, that's where you go to the hospital. You start to work in a team, basically. They put you in a team where there are like different doctors and other students from different years, and then you start to see patients. And yeah, that's how it is. So something interesting about second year is that now you do dissections. So dissections, basically, it's where you go to this room and there are like cadavers in this room. So cadavers is basically bodies of people who have passed away, who have given themselves to to medical schools or to schools so that you can learn with them. So like every Monday where we went there, and then we had our own cadaver, and then we used to dissect. If you're learning about the heart, you have to dissect and get to the heart, and then you see the heart, how it is, where it's located. And those things that you actually saw in the textbook is the things that you see on the real heart, which is very cool. So yeah. Medical school is very interesting. At UCT especially, it's very nice. And I'm very biased because this is all I know. I've been exposed to UCT Medical School. And if you're in high school, you want to do medicine, UCT is for you. If you want to come to UCT, it's possible. You don't have to belong to a certain socioeconomic status. If your marks are good enough, you can do it. It's something that you can do. There are a lot of misconceptions about medical school, the fact that you won't have a life and all those things. I think that you make it what you want it to be. Obviously, as I said before, like, you just have to prioritize what's important to you at that moment. And another thing, if you're in high school, just know what you want to do, preferably earlier on. No pressure if you don't know, and you're not sure and you're in grade 11. It's okay, still have time, but at least have an idea of what you want to do, because once you get to grade 12, it's a time now where you have to apply. And if you want to do medicine, you should start working hard, like, from as early as you can, from high school, whenever. When you're in grade 11, your grade 11 is very important. I can't stress this enough. And if you're in grade 10 going to grade 11, this is something that you should know. It's important. Grade 11 is very important. It can actually change the trajectory of your life, because it's the report that you're going to use to apply to the schools. And some universities take your grade 11 mark very important. You might do very well in grade 12, but if in grade 11 you didn't do so well, it might actually affect you. So I would advise you to take school seriously from where you are, even if you're in grade 9, if you're in grade 10, grade 11, grade 12, don't just start in grade 12. A lot of people say, I'll start working hard when I'm in grade 12. It does not work like that. That's my advice. And also, when you start applying, for those who will be going to grade 12 next year, apply to as many universities as you can. I can't stress this enough. This is one of the mistakes that I made. I didn't apply to a lot of universities. I think now South Africa has 10 medical schools. That makes you stand a good chance into getting in, because it's very competitive. I would tell you that it's very competitive. I know a lot of people who had very good marks who didn't make it to medicine because of how competitive it is. So apply to all of them. And I know sometimes finances might come in the way, because schools want you to pay an application fee, but if you can sacrifice something for it, just do it, you know, just do it. It's about your future. And yeah, and whichever university, if it's medicine that you want, whichever university that takes you, you will go, because at the end of the day, you just want to be a doctor. I know there's certain people, they might feel discouraged if they don't get the university they want. And now people are in grade 12 probably waiting for their results next year in 2026, and you get accepted in another university you didn't want. Just think about it. What is the dream? The dream is not the university. It's for you to become whatever you want to be. If it's becoming a doctor, that it is. So just go for it. And then lastly, if you are still in undergrad, still in first year, second year, below me, my advice would be, like, make connections. Know people who are like above you in terms of, like, the years. People are like in fourth year. If you're in third year, have someone who's in fourth year, someone that you can ask questions, someone that will give you information. You realize that sometimes you succeeding is not about it's not about the amount of money you have. It's about the people that you know. So just put yourself out there, know people, and also be willing to help others as well. If you are in third year and know someone in second year, pull them in, help them out, share resources. And that's what actually keeps you going. Yeah, that's how we got here. It's because of people. It's because of people who are, like, very generous enough to share information. And I urge you to do the same with others as well. Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, and yes, that's it about medical school at the University of Cape Town. If you made it this far, thank you so much for watching. I genuinely hope you got more inspiration or like an overview, an idea of what to expect or what it actually really like, what is really like at medical school at the University of Cape Town. So just don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and comment, and leave any questions in the comment section below. And if it has to do something with medicals, I'll definitely ask Divine to hop into the comment section below and answer you guys. And to Divine, thank you so much, Divine, for sharing your experience with us in this channel. And yeah, man, I genuinely just hope that you guys really loved it, and feel free to bring more recommendations in the comment section below of who you want me to invite next into the channel, like in which department, which industry, which faculty, like which field, which career path would you guys like to have an overview of in this channel. So just feel free to let me know in the comment section below. And hey, let's just move on to a little bit of behind the scenes, or just bloopers of the making of this video. So hey, have fun and enjoy. Don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Cheers.
Divine,
it's critical. Okay, hi, my name is Divine. I'm very nervous, but hey. Okay.